Now we are getting into the branding strategy. Last few slides where we were talking about the different components of brand, right? Now, branding strategy has primarily four components. These are four critical components. You can have 5, 7, 10, doesn't matter. But primarily, the critical ones are these four. Starts with branding decision. Second is brand architecture. Third is brand positioning statement. And fourth is brand personality. Now, why are these four critical? The reason being that whatever marketing activities you do, whatever assets you build, whatever product you build, whatever positioning you have, everything will be derived from these four critical components. Your marketing plan, you know, your brand guidelines, everything will be derived from these four critical components. So moving ahead, it's a choice of the business to brand themselves unless the customer helps the business in branding, right? So if you have a perception about Apple, Apple built great products, you know? So that is the reason you as a customer accepted Apple as a brand, right? But in many of the cases, a brand has to take a decision whether or not a company has to take a decision, a business has to take a decision whether they want to build themselves as a brand or not. Now, there are a couple of advantages of being a brand. You are easily identifiable. You have price protection. You can charge premium for sure. Apple charges premium, right? Laptop manufacturers or mobile manufacturers. They have legal protection. To launch products, it's easier for them because they have a good distribution channel. Rather, I would say they have a great distribution channel. Apple sells its products mostly from the Apple outlets, right? And from online mediums. But the brand is so good that people will reach out to all those distribution channels and they'll try and buy from there, right? So there are selective channels depending on what kind of business you are into, what kind of products you have, and that channel only is relevant for you, right? Now, loyal following for sure. I'm a good example of that. Helps in segmentation of the market. So Apple knows in India earlier, you know, people used to buy Samsung, Nokia, other mobile phones. But most recently, in last 3 years, people are buying, you know, iPhone at a much larger pace than they used to do earlier. The reason being that Apple has segmented their markets properly in India. So if if you are young, you don't have an earning, then you are one of the segments for Apple, which will be mapped with one of their SKUs or one of their products. If I'm a working person, Apple knows that this particular demographic has the potential to buy a 1 lakh, 120 lakh phone, right? So that segmentation for a brand is easier to do as compared to a non-brand identity, right? Then you have the customer acceptance and all of that. Now, if you talk about if you don't brand, you are a generic, unbranded business. It's plainly packaged, less expensive. The reason being that they are not investing much in branding. So they are less expensive compared to, you know, a well-established brand like Apple. Lower costs, they don't have a lot to lose. And mostly this happens with manufacturers who are OEMs, right? Who produce for a different manufacturer, who produce components for a different manufacturer. So those people don't need to be a brand. Giving you an example, in IFB, they have an alcohol plant. So they produce 92% pure alcohol. It's an OEM. They sell it to, brands, companies like, actually those are not companies, those are bottling plants. Blender's Pride, you have heard of, you know. So they sell these OEMs, they sell these products to the end the B2B manufacturer who sells directly to the end consumer. right? So they do the distillation, they do the bottling. So the packaging cost is low. They will package in scale. They don't need advertising, right? Because B2B customers come to them directly. And their retailer gets, pricing freedom. For instance, if I'm trying to sell, let's say an unbranded mobile phone to you, and you are going to be the brand, let's say Nokia, right? So you are going to do the packaging, you are going to do the labeling of the product, right? And then you are going to the market and selling it. So you have a lot of overhead costs. You have costs for marketing, you have costs for sales, you have costs for operations, you have costs for packaging. So n number of costs you have. But for me, those costs are not there. And therefore, for me, it's easier to sell at a lower cost and make greater margin compared to you, right? If you're going out in the market and selling directly to the end customer.